top is all bonded together now. So the next step is glassing those seams on either side. As we said in a previous episode, we have learned that we do need to fair these out properly before we put gel coat on it. The thing that really got me through this process of making sure that everything was aligned is the fact that majority of this is going to have either solar panels on it or non-skid. Non-skid hides a lot of sins. So anything that's kind of uneven there that normally you would see in a reflection is going to be non-skid, basically from this point aft and maybe even the strip forward here. This, of course, will not be. That's where the traveler goes. And aft there, all the way back at that beam, it's going to be actual gel coat too. So those are the priority spots. The rest of it is going to be non-skid. But now we got to sand off that gel coat and get that level surface. And then I have to do the same thing basically from the underside, clean that all up and get ready for glass, hopefully this week.
A few episodes back, you'll have seen that we invited Sophie from Ryan and Sophie Sailing to come help us for the day, exposing her to what it's really like to build a boat. At first, we gave her the easy job of sitting on top of the deck to fill and glass the seams which Matt had just sanded. But later in the afternoon, we let her try out the next straining work of glassing above your head. And with that project done, we were able to move on to another important part of our cabin top. Today inside the tent, Matt and I are going to do more reinforcements to our cabin top there. And now that we have the three separate pieces bonded together, we're actually going to reinforce the underside of the aft part. And not only will that keep rigidity through the three pieces, but because our traveler is going to get bolted through from the other side, that's going to create a nice surface for that to bolt into and to give it structure. For this project, we're going to be using coosa board, and that is a very dense foam that is reinforced by fiberglass. So Matt has just measured out the distance, or I should say we both have, and let's head over to the table saw and strip those pieces down.
So the beam we are making is roughly 80 millimeters, so just over 3 inches by 3 inches. The coosa that we're using is 12 millimeters, so just under a half inch. Roughly the 9 strips. 8 strips will do it, but I want to flare it out a little bit more at the ends. Stagger the joints then, bond them together to get our 3 inch thickness. Then there's a ton of laminates that go on top of it, a bunch of unidirectional on either side. It gets wrapped with a bunch of double bias and the 90 degree that we have. Just tons of layers in it. So it's just basically acting as a core. That's the reason why we can use pieces and stack them together, is because it's only for compression. The real strength has come from all that glass that's going to be in there. It's a good thing we don't have to do this often. Table's fairly small here, and we don't really have a feed table at all. So.
Not gonna fit. So joint here, joint there, solid pieces. The joints don't really matter, but I'm gonna do it anyway. So now we're gonna take a piece, one, and cut it in half. We're at the halfway mark, so it's that side.
Once we had 8 strips cut, which were 3 inches wide and 8 feet long, we then needed to cut them into smaller lengths as we were staggering out the joints for piecing them together. This is done so we could get the necessary 3.2 meters of length of the beam. Now that we had all our pieces cut to their proper sizes, it was time to bond them together. Using thickened resin containing long strand milled glass fibers, we catalyzed the mix and filled a piping bag for effortless application to the coosa board. To give it an even spread, Matt cut down one of our squeegees into a trowel, which would let the resin spread itself easily once the pressure of the next layer was added. And the thing is that these scars are scary, but they are just small scars. We should never be afraid of them. Layer by layer, we bonded the pieces together, making sure to include a little extra resin where the joints met. So I just close my eyes and dream about our kids and how they're running around. Won't you come and lay down next to me? Close your eyes and we'll be free. I'll keep my head. Originally, the plans of this beam called for Western red cedar. But since the traveler sits on top and bolts through every 4 inches, if water were to get in, it would eat away at the core and the beam would lose all of its strength. So we went with coosa board instead, which we did get approved by the designer.
All of the pieces have been put together now using our total boat structural putty. And I think altogether we did one round of 24 ounces and another of 8. So 32. Made sure they're straight, and now we're just kind of clamping them all together as it cures. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Stagger joints and let this sit overnight.
I love learning new things, but between a full-time boat build and a full-time editing job, I don't have the endless hours necessary to search the internet for the resources that I need. I'm short on time and I need a one-stop shop for gaining new skills, which is why I use Skillshare, the sponsor of this portion of the video. They're an online learning resource with thousands of classes over a large array of topics. Right now, I'm focused on learning new editing tips, including color correction, to help me with my white balance issues in the tent. There's a great instructor, Jordy Vandeput, who helps take an intermediate like me and give me more in-depth lessons that I had a hard time learning on my own, and teaches me new tricks I've never even heard of before. I know my interests are not the same as everyone's, but the good news is they do have something for everyone. Whether you want to get in touch with your creative side by taking one of their art courses, or get a better understanding of finances, they are going to have the courses you need. Make sure to click the link in our description box below, and the first 1,000 people to use the link will get a 1-month premium free trial of Skillshare. So start your path of learning something new today at no cost to you. I swear it seems to be every time we pull up the camera, walk outside, the travel lift goes on, but oh well, it's launching season, what can you do? Yesterday, Matt and I got a very important shipment in of our very wide sheets of fiberglass. Normally, we just get like the little 5 to 6 inch rolls because those are what we need to bond pieces together. But because we got the big one in, now we can work on that beam of all of the glassing that needs to be done to it and vacuum bagging it, which is something that we haven't done in nearly a year now. So we're very excited to see how that turns out.
I I'm all changed into work clothes right now and ready to get covered in resin, which I'm sure is going to be happening. We're not going to be rolling hand laminating today, so hopefully don't get too covered, but you never know. And we have great temperatures. We're starting out the morning right now in the low 60s, which will give Matt and I plenty of work time as we first apply all of the resin and the fiberglass. And then later this afternoon, it's supposed to get up to about 70 degrees, which should be enough for everything to cure, but if not, we might still cover it and put heaters on it. But fingers crossed that everything works out, because we need this structural and strong. We've already got the beam on the table here, ready to go. Matt has the compressor down there, which he checked yesterday. And I think he's ready to...
I am ready. It's cool. Last time we did this project, we ended up having to run the pump for like 10 hours or something ridiculous. And just not fun listening to that thing go all the time. So hopefully this will be just an hour or two and it should be ready to go. I don't remember if this unidirectional is 300 or 400 grams. I think it's 400.
The ends of this beam have been tapered down, so they still fit where the cabin top curves in, and Matt had also shaved down an area of notches to fit into the flange.
Every time! We have our sheet of plastic down. Matt is currently pulling out these strips of unidirectional fiberglass, which will go on top, and the way he told me that we're going to do this is just to put the beam on, coat that biznitch in resin, and then lay on the glass. So it should be quick and easy, much better than when we were doing the dagger board cases.
Is that a direct quote?
I may have added the biznitch.
Biznitch? I don't think so. But yes, we are just going to pour resin basically on this and wet it out and then slap it together, vacuum bag it, and hope for the best.
How many layers of unidirectional do we have here?
Six layers, so three on each side, which equals 1,200 grams, basically 39 ounces of cloth then. And then it gets layered three layers of double bias, which equals another 1,200 grams, and lots and lots and lots of vinyl ester.
New thing of vinyl ester getting a pump on. Fresh 5-gallon barrel.
At least the vinyl ester is. This pump is she's no longer in fighting shape.
That's 32.
That's 24. That's 24.
To get our layers of unidirectional fiberglass on, I would first wet them out on the table, and then the two of us would place it on the beam, where Matt would better adhere it and fill in any spots I had missed. Our sheets of 12-ounce double bias fiberglass would wrap all the way around. And since this glass likes to pull apart when wet, we decided the best route to go was to wet it once it was on the beam, coating and rotating it until we'd reached our starting point. When it was time for the next layer, we'd rotate the beam once again so none of our edges of fiberglass were sitting in the same place. A layer of peel ply went on top, and then we covered it with fabric to soak up excess resin. The last step was to encompass it in a bag and seal it shut with double-sided tape.
Air bubbles out of the tape so that when we turn the pump on, it is completely airtight.
So they do make tubes that you can get where you have to slide the thing in, and then you only have to seal the ends. I was thinking about doing that, but I thought it'd be very, very difficult to slide this thing in without taking everything with it.
Yeah.
Not sure if that would have been the better approach.
And the resin will start soaking into the cloth here. That is the nice thing with vacuum bagging too, is you don't have too much resin on there. It will soak up the excess. So when we're going on there, we can kind of slap it on just to make sure everything was staying in place. And now anything that isn't necessary for bonding gets taken out.
And here, one here.
Here, one right there.
Oh, there's another one.
Nicely compressing into those spots.
Vacuum bagging does make the process so much easier when you're working with multiple layers of glass. Usually we don't do it unless it's a very glass intensive project like this, just because it is kind of a waste of materials. The bags can be used once, the tape can be used once. We don't like to do that, but it is going to give us a very nice strong finish, which is good. How long are you going to run the puck for?
Until it's cured. The nice thing is you can typically feel, I mean, you can see it move around in there. Once that stops, you know it's fairly cured. And then we'll just leave it on for a little bit longer than that. And it'll be good.
After leaving the beam inside with the compressor going for probably just a little over an hour, Matt decided to bring it outside, take it into the sun, let it warm up and make sure it fully cured. And it looks like he's peeled off the bag just a little bit. Haven't fully unwrapped it yet, but I think everything is looking good so far. And going through the next steps for it, whatever that may be. Everything compressed down as should be?
It did. It just, we used 1% for the catalyst, and it took a lot longer than what I anticipated it.
Yeah, and it was going to take a long time to warm up today.
So I did pull it off the vacuum a bit early. It should be fine. Let's see how many wrinkles are in this box. Bake for a little bit longer.
All right.
A little tacky there.
That's right, we got time.